No, actually, I didn't have time to take proper art lessons. I actually came straight from another Channel 8 production. So I didn't have time to go and do the art lessons. It was something that I really wanted to do, but unfortunately, we didn't have the time. So what we did was that they got a girl from NAFA. Her name is Eunice, and she's basically my hand double for the close-ups, you know, when they're focusing on the painting. In the shots where you kind of like see the back of the thing and then I'm just doing my thing, she also helped me with some directions on how to look a little bit more authentic. We were in Paris for about a week. I personally have a very, very soft spot for Paris. It was a huge challenge because the era that we were supposed to be filming in is supposed to be about 1920s, 30s, 40s. It was a huge challenge to avoid modern structures, it could be even like a rubbish bin. You know, we had to actually find places where you can't see anything of the current world. So I thought that was incredibly challenging for them. In Paris, we filmed in the Musée d'Orsay. We filmed along the River Seine. Basically, we didn't have a lot of choice simply because of all the restrictions regarding, you know, being able to see modern structures and all that. But I had the best time, whatever it was. When we were in Musée d'Orsay, I got to see Van Gogh's self-portrait. And I mean, to me, it is just not something that you can see online. And when it's so different when you see it in person, because for me, the thing that stood out for that piece was his eyes, you know, and eyes, hands are the hardest things to paint. I could feel that he was a tortured soul. I could feel the mental illness that he was suffering, and that one piece just changed everything for me. All my opinions about art being highfalutin, all my being intimidated by the world of art just flew out the window, because it was just a human kind of like a connection. I still do, like, right from the beginning, I still do like that portrait of Eugene Chen, because I think that she captured his eyes, and his eyes appear very mysterious in that piece, and there's just such a mystery about it. What is he looking at, and what is he thinking of? You know, a lot of people were like me when I was approached with this project. And I never heard of Georgette Chen. They told me it was about art, and I was like, art is intimidating, you know, and art sometimes can come across as pretentious. That was my first, you know, impression, and then I got to read some more, and I got to kind of understand what they were trying to do with this project. And I felt that it was, you know, beyond all the glamour, beyond all the Star Awards, beyond all the trappings of a celebrity, you know, there are certain things that you can do with your celebrity to make a positive change on society, or even maybe on individuals. My main work is in Channel 8. To bring heartlanders and kids, younger kids, okay, to just kind of take some tentative baby steps towards understanding art, understanding what art is about, and not be intimidated by it. Yeah. And so I just felt that, okay, this would be one of those times that I could use my celebrity for something that is worthy of just myself or somebody else.